Hi friend, it's Ron from CamMastery.com, where you can go to learn how to make great videos with Camtasia. This is a free lesson Friday, which means you get a free lesson right from my Camtasia Mastery course. If you want to get the entire course, you can head over to CamMastery.com/store and pick up that course. Now, onto the video. I want to show you a couple more things with tracks, and it's really to get to the detail of what we see in the timeline. So we're going to start off by looking at the detail by zooming in down here. So if I look at this, I have a lot of information here. It looks like 40 minutes worth of information. And a lot of these things are really skinny and I can barely see them. So I want to zoom in so I can maybe see this section of my timeline. Now the easiest way to do that is just grab this and start dragging. Now I want you to notice where my playhead is over here. And watch what happens as I start to drag and drag and drag. Notice my playhead stays on there the whole time. It wasn't really zooming into the middle. It was zooming to where my playhead was. So if I wanted to zoom into that one section, and I think that section was here, make sure your playhead is there, and then drag, zoom, zoom, and then you can see, okay, yes, it is in fact zooming into that section. So that's the first thing. Secondly, you can use the plus and minus if you just want to zoom in one piece at a time. You can do that. So one click, zooming in or zooming out is another option for you. And if I want to, I can hold down the control key with my mouse wheel, and I can zoom in that way. So if I hold down control and scroll up, it zooms in, hold down control and scroll down, and it zooms out. We can also zoom by going up to the view menu, timeline, and we can see zooming in and out, control shift plus to zoom in, control shift minus to zoom out. So if you remember for the canvas, it was control plus and control minus to zoom in and out. For the timeline, a little bit different, control shift and the plus and minus keys to zoom in and out, respectively. They also have that zoom to fit, so you can see the entire project on your timeline, and you can zoom to maximum, that's zooming in all the way, or you could zoom to a selection. So if I had a selection here, this probably isn't a good selection because I'm zoomed pretty far in. I probably want a larger selection than that. So let's say I want this, I could go view, timeline, and then zoom to selection, and then it says, okay, I'll show you that piece that you highlighted. One other thing we can do here is we can increase track heights. All right, so looking over here on the left, we see the height of a track. And the track heights are fine. I usually keep them at this position. Those are the smallest that they can be in Camtasia 9. What I can do is go to view, and I can say, well, let's increase the track height. And notice everything got a little bit taller. So I could see more tracks. Now I only see three. Well, let's try that again. View, timeline. Let's increase the track height again. Now I can only pretty much see two. Now the reason we would want to do this usually is to see the detail in the audio. I want to see these peaks, or I want to see the valleys. I want to see where there's silence. And that's the primary reason that I would choose to zoom in and out of my tracks. You could see when we went to view and zooming on the tracks that it also told us we have Alt in the plus sign or Alt in the minus sign to do that. So I'll try that here on my keyboard, Alt plus, and I can see my tracks are getting bigger and bigger and bigger, Alt minus, and now my tracks are getting smaller and smaller. And then similarly to the slider to go in and out here, we can use this slider to zoom in and out as well. So I can zoom way in to the point where I can't even see all of the audio on the track. Now you might not want to get quite that detail, so I'll zoom this back down. But again, if you need to see the detail here in audio, you can go in here, grab this slider, slide it up as far as you want, or use the keyboard shortcuts. Now, one of the things that I mentioned to you is that I typically only do this for audio. Now, as I scroll up, I can see all of my tracks got really large, and that might not be what I want. If I really just want to see audio, let's do this. Let's grab all my tracks, make them all short. But now if I put my mouse here between tracks 1 and 2, this will affect the track that is below where your mouse is. So I can click and hold this and drag this up, and now my audio stretches out large. And then I look at the other tracks and they are still at that smaller height. So when I choose to change the track height, it's usually only the audio. So I would go in, stretch this audio out as far as I need. When I'm done, I stretch it back down and I'm ready to move on to the next thing.